In the previous video, we have configured the database and now we can start managing data in our endpoints. Let's start with products. In our database, we have a table called products, so in our code, I want to have a representation of a single row of this table. Let it be a plain PHP class product, created here right in products namespace. It should contain an ID, a name, and a price. I make all these properties public, and the product now looks like a simple DTO. Maybe later we will add some real logic here. Create a constructor that instantiates all of them. ID is integer, name is a string, and price is float. Add doc blocks. OK, done. Not yet very useful, but it is a good starting point. Then we need to somehow map the rows from our database into instances of product, something between a persistence layer and the entity itself. Let's call it a storage, created here in products namespace. It will be a wrapper on top of MySQL connection that encapsulates all low-level query details. So the first feature that we are going to implement will be creation of a new product. Let's say we have a name and a price and we want to create a new instance of product and store it in the database. Add a new method create and it returns a promise. The promise will resolve once the query is done and the product is persisted. Or the promise will reject in case of a failed query. Insert into table products name and a price. And provide the values. Then we continue chaining and I want to return a promise that resolves with an instance of a new product. So here we add a function and process the query result. From the callback return a new product. As an ID we use insertID property of query result object. And inject name with price. Done. Now let's update the controller. First of all, we need to inject our storage. Add a constructor. Inside method invoke, replace this product array with separate variables, name and price. Then call a storage. Now notice that we can't send a response here after create call, because since the promise runs asynchronously, this would simply mean that I run the code immediately before we actually persist data into the database. Because now the code here, where we return a response, doesn't wait for the create call to finish. So instead, I want to send a response from inside a then block, when I know that it was successful. So here the callback receives an instance of product and we can return it in the response. We can't return an object here, so we need to manually cast it to array. Inside product create a method to array and return attributes of product as array. Of course, we can just convert it using typecasting, but I want to have a full control. Now, in a response, let's just return a product as an array. In case of error, we return internal server error. And return a promise from the controller. So the controller is ready. Let's update the server code. First of all, we import a storage. And I want an alias products. Then we create an instance of products storage. Provide a connection. Remove this dummy query. Then inject products into create product controller. By the way, while we're here, let's inject products into all product-related controllers. Okay, start NodeMon and let's see how it works. Open requests file. Search for products creation and run. And it works. We have received a product object. Let's see what we have in our database. Yes, here is our new product. Product creation is done, and we move on to the next product-related endpoint. For example, let's try to fetch a product by its ID. Open a storage and create a method getByID. Inside we query products table where ID equals a specified one. Then in a callback here, we map a database row into our product object. In result rows, we get an array of returned rows. In our case, we need the first one. Instantiate a product with the values from this row. Don't forget to cast ID to integer and price to float, because we receive them from the database as strings. We resolve a promise with an instance of product. But what should we do if there is no such product in our database, when result rows is empty? Should we resolve the promise with null? We can make it more explicit and reject the promise by throwing an exception. What kind of exception? We can create our own one, something like product not found. Create a new class, inherited from runtime exception. We don't need constructor here. At this point, the storage is done. We can update the controller. Get product by ID. Add a constructor and inject a storage. Inside method invoke, we call this storage getByID. Then, on success, we receive an instance of product and return this object, just like we did it in creation. Now we need to catch product not found errors, and in this case, we return a 404 response. We don't have such response constructor, so let's quickly add a new one. Open JSON response class and add a new static constructor not found. Inside, return an instance with 404 status code. Done. Move back to the controller and return JSON response not found. I also want to catch all unexpected errors and return an internal server error. Cool, with that we have one more working endpoint. Let's try it. In products table we have a record with ID 1. Make a request. Here is our product. Now let's also try an invalid ID. So I am sending a GET request for ID which doesn't exist. And we get 404. This endpoint works nice. Now we can fetch an individual product and we can store a product. And of course we also have our general GET method where I want to return all the products we have. So let's also take care about this. Again, open storage and add a new method getAll. Here we query all records from products table. Then we need to map all received records into product objects. We already have this logic here, So let's extract a method. Add new method. It accepts a raw database record and returns an instance of product. Ok, now we can use ArrayMap function and map database rows into product objects. Done. Now open the controller. Add a constructor and inject a storage. Then we call this storage getAll. On success, we receive an array of product objects. Before we return them in response, we cast them to plain arrays like this, using ArrayMap. As always, if the promise rejects, we return 500 error. I don't like these nested callbacks. Let's extract a method, map products. And having a method, we can type hint our array. Like this, we are accepting any number of product class objects. And just paste a call of ArrayMap here. This map products. Ok, now let's try a general GET request. If I send this, we get back an array with this one object, with this one product. Ok, let's try to delete a product. As always, we start with a storage. Add a new method delete, which accepts an ID and returns a promise. Here we make a delete query, where ID equals a specified one. Then we check the result. If affected rows equals 0, that means that we have tried to delete an invalid product. In this case, we throw an exception. Then in controller, again inject a storage. Then we use the storage to delete a product with a provided ID. In case of success, we can return a 204 no content response. Open JSON response and let's add a new static constructor here. No content. And create an object with 204 status code. Done. Now in controller, we call JSON response no content. And we add two error handlers, one for 404 response and one for unexpected error with 500 response. Ok, let's try how it works. Here I have a delete request. Send it. And we get back 204 response. To prove that it works, we can fetch all products again with a get request. We should receive an empty array, but we have an empty response body. Looks like there is a bug here. Let's see. Get all products controller. We receive an empty array. And make a JSON response. Yes, here in the constructor we should explicitly check null, fix it. Run the request and we get an empty array. So we successfully deleted the product. Then let's try to remove the same product one more time. And we got 404 as expected. So with that, there is one method we haven't implemented, and that is incomeInputRequest. When we want to change our object, when we want to change data in the database. Let's also work on that to finish that product setup. Create a new method in storage. We will allow to change the name and a price of the product. Update query can be a bit tricky. In update, we cannot detect whether there is no record with such ID or there is no need in updating a field value. So we need to find a product first. And if there is such record in the database, we perform an update. Update products, set name and price. And we provide name, price and ID. Of course, we get an ID from the received product. So the resulting promise rejects with product not found or resolves on successful update. Open the controller, inject a storage and perform an update. Like we did it in the product creation, extract a name and a price from the request. Then call this storage update. Provide ID, name and a price. Then on success we return 204 response. Here we may face two kinds of errors. The first one, product not found is expected, and we return 404 response. For all other unexpected errors, we return a server error. Done. So let's try this out and let's see what happens if we try to update a product. At this moment we have no products in the database, so let's create a new one. Quickly run a GET request. The product was stored. Let's fetch its ID. And then I'll run a PUT request here. If I send this, I get 204 response. Again run a GET request and we have an updated product. Now its price is 2800. And with that we have a first draft of how the product's routes could work and look like. Obviously this is not final and we might need more fields than just name and the price. But it's nice to get started. And we already achieved something very important. We got the first version of the RESTful API where we actually persist data in the database.